Glass is a lot like life. It's colorful, fragile, and changeable.
Instead of talking out my situations, I guess I just got into fist fights. And like, I had to learn the hard way that, you know, talking it out isn't like the punkish way, I guess. It's like, it's the right thing to do.
In trouble with the law, these young women weren't sentenced to juvenile detention, but instead enrolled in this free class that teaches glass art and subtle lessons on life.
If I hadn't gone here, I don't know where I'd be now versus, you know, where I am today.
Jason Lee Middle School is one of several sites for the class. It's on the edge of Tacoma's Hilltop, where high crime in the 1990s drew not only national attention, but the concern of Tacoma-born artist Dale Chihuly. He and others started Hilltop Artists to teach inner-city kids self-esteem through self-expression. This program, Arts Connect, is now part of that.
And I was like, seriously, you're gonna give me this awesome, fun privilege, like, for doing something wrong? I didn't understand it, but I think that it's a really great thing to do to help people with something inspirational.
This girls-only probation and diversion program is the only one of its kind in the U.S.
When we started the program, we were looking at the community and all the programs that there were for boys, and there weren't any programs for girls.
Through art, these teens learn the value of teamwork.
It's cool. It's a good experience because I don't have that many friends, so, like, yeah. Good to talk to people, I guess.
I already dumped it, though. It shattered.
Learning that in art, as in life, success comes from solving problems.
Do you see how that correlates? How the art, like, you've made mistakes and it's been disappointing, but then that taught you something to make a better decision for down the road, right?
Probation officer Rebecca Villa helps lead the program.
You guys understand this tool, the glass cutting tool?
She, Kate Pascal, and Lauren Appel are showing these young women a new way.
That's awesome. Yeah. Well, good for you.
Thank you.
Yeah. And this is a way to try and build their self-confidence. And maybe it's just that simple, that we're getting them to like themselves. And they see they can create something beautiful, start to like themselves, and then be able to move on to other areas.
We're teens. We make mistakes. We learn from them.
When I first came into the program, I thought there was just going to be like a whole bunch of violent girls and there would be like fights every minute. But no, it was actually this like really calm group.
If anything, it's just a good opportunity to get out of the house and talk to people who can relate to your situation and just kind of kick back and mellow out a little bit.
It's a lot easier to change the way you act and the things you do than I thought it would be.
Yeah, there's a lot of learning going on right now.
And not just about glass.
There's some gloves if you guys just kind of want to circulate those around, grab a pair.
In this session, the young women also tend this vegetable garden outside the class. A new experience for many.
We're going to think about how what we're doing in the garden is related to what we're doing with the art and how they can influence and inspire back and forth. So
we're planting sunflower seeds. This is kind of a symbol of the idea of a wind chime and art piece that they're making and how you have to take certain steps in order to grow the idea.
Some of this produce they take home to eat.
A lot of the girls that we work with don't have that much access to food, or their families or their friends would really benefit from having access to fresh grown fruits and vegetables.
Dinner is provided at the end of each class. The students also select a service project, in this case donating their art, or money from selling it, to the Gallucci Learning Garden on Tacoma's Hilltop. That's where
you can take people with very little gardening experience, give them a free resource that is explicitly supporting the community garden program, and they will have great success. They will get a lot of great food.
It feels good to give back to the community.
When the young women aren't gardening, they're back in the art room, connecting the skills that it takes to do both.
I like it a lot.
You do.
I think it's really fun. It gets me away for a couple hours from all the crazy stuff going on, and it gives me a break. I love it.
I really enjoy art. Like, it helps me kind of keep off of trouble, so I'm glad that I'm in this.
Most of the girls who go through the program stay out of trouble a year later. At the end of this course, they proudly put their work on display.
Yeah, so it's not really a punishment because it's actually super fun. And the people, you go into it and you have no idea what's going to happen because you're going to end up in a room with a bunch of strangers that got in trouble too, and you're going to do art. And it's like, that's really weird, but you do it. And it's actually really fun because all the people in Arts Connect, they're really cool.
And we're going to start the bidding at 25.
The art auction supports the Gallucci Learning Garden, where their wind chimes will hang as a gift to the community and a symbol of lives transformed.
To remind me, like, oh, I did this, and it's a new me, I guess.
Do you like it? I made it for you.
I love it. Love it. She did an awesome job. So proud of you, baby.
I don't want to be into any trouble, and this is like a new beginning. Yeah.
For more information about the Arts Connect program, visit the Hilltop Artists website or give them a call at the number on your screen.